Let's see if we can learn a thing or two about 401ks. 401ks. And it's given this kind of cryptic name because that's the actual chapter or subchapter or section of the actual IRS code that defines it, the 401k. Now, it's a retirement plan like an IRA or a Roth IRA. So it's a retirement savings plan. Retirement savings plan. And as I start to describe it, you're going to find a lot of similarities between the 401k and an IRA. And then we'll talk about the differences. So the first similarity, and this is true of a 401k and a traditional IRA, is that contributions are tax deferred. Contributions tax deferred. Tax deferred. So when I, let's say I have $5,000 in a given year, if I put it into a 401k or into an IRA, I do not pay taxes on that $5,000. The mechanics are a little bit different. In a 401k, that never even gets included in your income. In an IRA, that does get included in your income, but when you actually contribute the amount, you're able to deduct that from your reported income. But I won't go into the details. The general gist is that they are tax deferred. You don't have to pay taxes on contributions. Now, the next similarity between a 401k and an IRA is that while the assets are in the account, earnings on assets or on your investments, not taxed while they are in the account. While they are in the account. And this in general is true of not just 401, let me do this in a different color. This is true not just of 401ks and traditional IRAs. This is also true of Roth IRAs. And we know the difference with the Roth is that you actually do pay taxes on your contribution. The good thing about the Roth, and we saw that in the Roth video, is that at the end, you won't have to pay any taxes on anything. But this video isn't about Roth IRAs, it's about 401ks. So if you were to withdraw before you're retired, so if you withdraw before 50 years old, and there are some exceptions under special circumstances where you are able to withdraw. But in general, if you withdraw before the age of 50, and this is true of 401ks and traditional IRAs, you pay taxes plus a 10% penalty. So they really want you to keep your money in there. And you might remember in the Roth IRA situation, you can always take at least the original principal that you contributed. You would have to pay taxes and penalties on any earnings. But in the Roth, you have more flexibility on your initial contribution. So this right here, so I just want to make it clear, this green only applies to, only the green applies to the 401, to really all of the IRAs and 401ks. This only applies to 401k and IRA, traditional. If I don't say anything next to the IRA, I imply that it's traditional. And this, of course, is also 401k and traditional IRA. And then once I am over 50, in a 401k, and this is also true of a traditional IRA, I just pay ordinary income. Ordinary income on withdrawal, which of course is different than a Roth IRA. Roth IRA, we pay taxes up front. When we withdraw, we pay no taxes. In 401k and traditional IRA, we don't pay taxes up front, and we defer them until when we actually take the money out of our account when we're over the age of 50. And like traditional IRAs, 401ks, they start incurring penalties if you don't withdraw, you don't start taking your minimum withdrawal at age 70 and a half. In a Roth IRA, you can just continue to leave your money in there. In a 401k or traditional IRA, you really should start taking your money out, otherwise you're going to have some pretty hefty penalties on you. Now, everything I've just described, you're like, gee, why are 401ks at all different than IRAs? Why does this different retirement savings plan even exist? And the answer there is that it actually addresses, it's more flexible. And it's more flexible in that, let me write it down here, 401k versus IRA, versus traditional IRA. So the first major difference is that you have a higher ceiling. So you have a higher annual limit. Higher annual limit. In a 401k, depending on what year, and it's going to increase over time, but in 2010, it's $16,500 is what you can contribute to your 401k. You have to make at least that amount of money, but if you make more than that, you can contribute up to $16,500. In an IRA, we learned if you're below the age of 50, you can only contribute in 2010 $5,000. If you're over the age of 50, they let you kind of catch up a little bit. In the 401k example, you could contribute as much as $22,000. In an IRA, you can contribute $6,000. But we're assuming we're under 50 for these examples. So there's a higher limit just to start with. There's also in the 401k situation, there's no income limits. Income limits for tax deductibility. And actually, if you really think about it officially, it's not even tax deductible. It never even gets included in your income. IRA does have income limits. Income limits exist, and you'll want to look it up on the web depending on what year and what your income's like. Both IRA, the traditionals, and the Roth will have some income limits. So this is more flexible there. And then the other interesting thing is that an employer might match it. And actually, before I even talk about that, that's the other distinction. This is organized by the employer, so your employer sets up a 401k plan, while this is you. You set up your IRA plan. And because the employer sets up a 401k plan, because they're setting it up, they might match. So employer matching might exist. So an employer, besides setting it up so you could set aside $16,500 a year, they might set it up so that they match some of that. And if you combine the employee contribution plus the employer contribution together, you can contribute as much as this is your employer plus you. You can only put $16,500, but combined, if you have a nice employer, you can contribute as much as $46,000. Once again, in an IRA, you're still just sitting there at $5,000. So on a lot of levels, you could imagine if you're kind of a wealthier individual, the IRA doesn't apply to you because you have income limits, and maybe $5,000 doesn't mean much to you. All of a sudden, $46,000 might mean a lot if you have a good employer who's willing to make the difference. You yourself can contribute $16,500 on a pre-tax basis, and then your employer can match some or all or even more than that to get you all the way to $46,000. And of course, these are the limits as in 2010. But everything else is identical, just like we saw up here. And there's some minor technicalities. You're not allowed to borrow money versus a traditional IRA. Your employer might let you borrow money versus a 401k. The 401k might be more restrictive in terms of what you're allowed to invest in, since the employer sets it up. The employer is the one that's going to choose what acceptable investments are inside of this 401k. An IRA, depending on your custodian, depending on who is handling that account for you, you might have a little bit more flexibility in what type of assets you put in your IRA. So in general, the math that we did in the IRA, the traditional IRA video, it would apply to the 401k, but instead of limiting ourselves at $5,000, we could put the number $16,500 there, or even $46,000, and of course, then the advantage becomes even larger.